Hey guys, it's Justin. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, we're going to be ranking Disney rides while we're at Epcot. All right, so today, as you just heard, we're going to be ranking Epcot rides. So we're here with this Taylor. Want to say hi?
Hey.
Yeah, and the Mama Matter up there.
Two are going to be to the right, one will be to the left. Enjoy your visit.
All right, first we're going to go on Spaceship Earth, so I'll see y'all while we're on it. We have yet to be here with the new fountain. I had to take my mic off for a minute, but there's a new fountain over there. I'll go showcase it here. We're here for the Festival of the Arts, so we normally like to come to Epcot during one of the festivals, so we're going to be eating around the world today. Ten something, 16? Is that what it is?
16 and like a half.
Oh, never mind then. The audio track online is about 10 minutes or so. Spaceship Earth, so neat. Love the smell of it in here. All right, we just got off Spaceship Earth. I'm gonna rank it out of 10. Obviously, if you've been on this ride, you know it's 100% 10 out of 10. It's a classic, ride it every time we go. I don't know what else there's to say about it. If you think this ride is boring because it's about history, like, something's wrong with you. Okay, now we're heading into the Land Pavilion to go eat semi-lunch. Normally we eat lunch in China later on, but we'll see. We're gonna go eat and then go ride Soarin'. Test track is a 95-minute wait, but that is not always true. We're hoping that it's not, so whenever we get there, let's just hope it's not. And then you also have to remember that they make you do a mobile order thing. Instead of going up there and waiting in line, you have to order on the app and stuff, so just have that in mind if you were to go here. Yeah, of course. It's amazing. Soundtracks of rides are...
These, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. It has long been used to make flour for baking. Another innovation at work here is our integrated pest management program, by natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using less.
All right, we just got off Living with the Land, and now we're gonna head on to Soarin', my apologies. I don't know what it is, but something about looking at plants is just amazing to me, and it's such a fun like ride, even though it's not thrilling at all. And it's a 10 out of 10, I would say. Maybe a 9, because it's clearly not like test track and stuff. But I would probably give it a 9, to be honest. So, Taylor's over here getting mad at me, but you know, whatever. Okay, so it is Martin Luther King Jr. weekend. So, it's more busy than it was whenever we were on here last time. It was not a walk-on, like last time. It was a walk-on, so we're like kind of backed up, but it's also not super bad, so we'll see. Obviously, I can't record on Soarin', but we just got off of it. Another 10, clearly. There's only one more that's gonna get a 10. The others are slightly below, so What? Figment is not getting a... No. No. Alright, now we're gonna head on the seas. Mine? Yeah. It's dark as crap every time you go into this building. So, I feel like I can't see squat. Here comes the best part here with the jellyfish. Don't even know if you can see it. Okay, we just got off Nemo. We're gonna head to Figment after we paint a paint by number thing over there for Festival of the Arts. But I will give Nemo a 6.5. Not quite a 7. I like Nemo. It's a good movie, but the ride, I mean, could be better. It's alright. If you have kids, they'll like it. The song at the end, Big Blue World's fun, so that's what I'll give it. We just got off of Figment. I'm gonna give that one a 6. It's, I mean, sure it's a classic, but it's, I don't know, something about it. Taylor loved it, so we never rode it before, and then Taylor all of a sudden made us ride it every time. Which, I mean, I don't hate it, but it's not my favorite for sure. All right, we're sitting down, so I took my mask off. We're about to go get on Test Track, which should be no secret that it's going to be the other one that gets a 10. I've ridden this 1,000 times. It's awesome. You get to create your own car, not during COVID, but normally you do. And a lot of people like the old one better than this one, but I kind of like this one better, to be honest, just because it's like futuristic and stuff. So we're about to get on that, and then we'll probably head over to the countries. I'll try to record on it. I've never recorded on Test Track because it's a fast ride and I don't want to lose my phone. So we'll see what I do. Probably my favorite ride in the entire park. Epic. This is what this park needed. If it didn't have Test Track, I mean, it had Soarin', but I feel like it would be way less interesting. Here we go.
Capability test to see how your vehicle designs perform under challenging weather and surface conditions.
I know. All right, we just got off Test Track. I tried to record a little bit, but it's a very, very fast ride, so it's clearly difficult to do so and not lose your phone. So, like I said before, 10 out of 10. So, great ride. We're gonna head to the countries now. We got a Festival of the Arts thing so we can put stickers down for everywhere we go and what we eat and whatnot. So let's go. All right, now we're in line in Mexico to go get nachos. And then my sister and my mom are at Pop Eats, which is a pop-up shop for Festival of the Arts. And they're getting these like pretty much Pop-Tarts. They're really, really good. I had one last time we were here. But this line's pretty long, so we're separated. They're waiting there and we're here, so. Then we're gonna go into Mexico, my favorite pavilion.
Got this again. It is so good. Oh my gosh.
This is new. This is Dante from Coco. I don't know why they paint on the outside of the whole thing, but I mean, it looks pretty cool.
Remember me, though I have to say goodbye. Remember me. Don't let it make you cry.
We just got out of Mexico. We're in the China Pavilion now. Taylor got a drink, hated it. A really alcoholic beverage, no. Just really bad. It was, what was it called?
Butterfly C?
Butterfly tea.
C butterfly,
something like that. I don't know. But right now we're
tasted
in...
Tasted like a doctor's office smells.
Tasted like a doctor's office smells, she said. So that sounds appetizing. We're in China, and the Lotus Blossom restaurant, which is apparently closed, is actually open. And we're about to get food, even though we're not really hungry.
So we're at the Lotus Blossom. We didn't ride Grand Fiesta Tour or Frozen because we're going to try and hopefully get done with the countries and then go ride Test Track again later tonight before they close. But normally I would give Fiesta Tour a probably like a 6 or a 7. I mean, I like the music, but it's not like my favorite ride. And then Frozen's pretty good. I'd probably give it like an 8. I don't know if I like it more than Maelstrom, which was what used to be there, but it's still a good ride. Is Taylor enjoying her Chinese?
Oh, can you take drinks in there?
I don't know. You're not supposed to have your mask off, but you know.
We're in France right now, and once you get out on this tree, you'll have a better view. But they have put up the Ratatouille sign. There you go, you can see it now, over in the distance. So, my favorite movie is getting its own ride. I'm very excited. We're waiting in line to get Taylor a bread bowl with cheese in it. They're like 2.5 hours, well, probably closer to 2 hours now until the park closes. So, pretty neat.
Even Molly said that bread bowl is the best. So.
Oh yeah.
And Disney Food Blog.
Shout out to Disney Food Blog and All Ears Net.
This fountain at nighttime is awesome looking.
Okay, we're back at our hotel. I'm about to end the vlog here, but I got this.
What?
I got this magnet that says, the only thing predictable about life is unpredictability, with Remy on it. From Ratatouille, of course. I like it. I got it from Before You Exit the Park. Taylor's over here singing Remy the Ratatouille musical.
The mouse of all the trees.
Mouse?
A rat of all the trees.
And then for finishing the picture around the world, like Festival of the Arts thing, you get this little prize where it's like a Mickey and you can build it. And it's 3D and you get an Epcot one. So I gotta put it together.
There's the little origami Mickey and Epcot ball. $7, but I mean, it's cool.